Hey everybody. So today I walked over to the store and talked to somebody there. One of those things where clearly he didn't remember my name, I didn't remember his, but you know, we recognized each other, we knew who we knew in common, whatever. And we were talking and I asked him, you know, what do you think this period is going to be called? Because, you know, at least in terms of economics, this is one of the big events of my life. I mean, I realize that intellectually it doesn't really feel like anything, though. But this, you know, this is right up there with 9/11 and the fall of 2008. And he didn't have any idea of what we'd be calling this period. And he asked me what I thought. And the only thing that's come to mind for me is the lockdown. But we're not really locked down. It's a voluntary lockdown. Whatever phrase, you know, gels to refer to this period, it's got to be short. It's got to be pithy. It's got to be easy to say. I don't know what it's going to be. I mean, do you remember 9/11? Some of you don't. Some of you weren't born. But most people, I think, who follow my output or my age or older. So yeah, we remember 9/11, but it wasn't called 9/11 on that day. I don't remember how long it took for that name to stick. But it wasn't immediate. So we are living in a period right now, which in the near future will have a pithy handle that will endure for decades, and it will be evocative, and people will be conjuring with it, and we don't know what it is. Anyway, as I walked to the store, there were kids out playing. I walked past a couple that I know, and you know, we smiled and greeted each other and said, "How you doing?" But we didn't pause. We just walked past each other. When I got to the store, I mentioned already, you know, I met somebody there that I shouldn't remember his name, but I don't. And, you know, he, as we parted, I think he called me Buddy, so he didn't remember my name either. The store was, there were a lot of people there, but it was a Saturday. I mean, it still is a Saturday. And a lot of, you know, there's more traffic in the store on a Saturday, so it wouldn't have been an unusual amount of traffic to me. But you know, walking in, there were signs in the entryway saying, "Hey, if you're sick, get somebody else to shop for you. Don't come in here sick. And if you just come from another country, don't come in here. We're sorry, but come on." And the shelves were pretty much fully stocked, but there were a couple of exceptions. One was the place that is, you know, where they usually have eggs and butter. I don't know why, but no eggs and butter. And the only other part of the store where I noticed empty shelves was the bread aisle. So I don't know what's going on with bread. I don't know. I mean, who knows from how far away it comes, what the transport routes are, how many times it gets handed off, you know, where along the way the interruption came. Was it at the bakery? You know, was it at a distributor somewhere? Is it just that, you know, people's stocking shelves are hard pressed to keep up? I just don't know. It's just strange, the things that, you know, they were out of. Eggs, butter, bread. They had everything else. All right, so what do you think this period's going to be called? And, you know, you're maybe not predicting the future, is writing it. You might be the person who comes up with the phrase. And it might propagate from the comment section of this video out to the internet and into history. It could be you. You could be the author of history. This is an important video. So, you know, type your suggestions below, and I will talk to you again later.